Yeah.
Episode 25.
To 25.
Where's my cup?
Isn't that a silver anniversary?
Is it liquor in here or is it just melted ice?
I don't know. I'm probably melted ice. I'm mad thirsty. Who cares? Episode 25. Welcome to another episode of Please Delete This. We live.
What up? But for the people listening tomorrow, we're not live.
No, no, we're not live. You missed it. I am Darren. Hello.
This is Bim. Hi.
Genevieve.
Wagwan peeps.
Hello, friends.
How you doing, people?
Ex-friends.
Ex-friends.
Former friends.
Who?
You.
What'd I do?
What?
Listen.
Hello.
You still got your mic with the red thing, right? We okay. Don't be mad. Don't be mad.
So y'all gonna start without me. I'm angry.
So we took way longer than usual setting up today.
Which means nothing to you guys.
Right. But it'll explain why Jen may be a little off today.
Has had 20 minutes to just sit in her anger.
20 minutes, bro.
Yeah, it's been at least an hour.
Almost.
Almost.
Yeah. Okay. So, but Jen has, what are you watching tonight? Big Brother?
Big Brother is starting in 2 minutes.
She wants to watch Big
and I'm
Brother.
I'm here with you two, so you're welcome.
And we were setting up equipment, and Darren wanted to go live, and I obliged him, of course, because he's my friend.
Yes.
But Jen isn't happy with anything that's been transpiring while Big Brother's on.
When you guys asked me to do this podcast, there was guidelines that we set.
What was that?
Because I said I wasn't going to do a podcast, and then finally I said, all right, I'll do it as long as it's audio only. Now we got two cameras looking at my black ass face.
You didn't rework your contract. After 5 episodes, the contract.
We weren't even supposed to do more than 5 episodes.
The contract shifted.
I'll show you a shift. I'll show you a shift. Anywho, start the shit up, Darren.
Let's get it.
I did.
But the other stuff. Ask the
guys,
question.
how was your weekend?
I don't fucking
your
know.
Week. How was the past?
I know.
Days? Oh, that's right. This guy was from Baltimore.
Oh, before that, I went to see Chris Brown.
Oh, yeah. How was that?
On Thursday. Dope show. He's like an android. I don't know how somebody can dance that much and sing live, because I was skeptical. I didn't know if he did a lot of lip syncing at his shows because of all the dancing. But, yeah, no, he was singing live. He sounded great. Dances were on point. Ran into a couple of people out there. Denisha, what up?
Hey, Brenna, hey.
What up?
Hey, girl.
And yeah, no, phenomenal show. Her was there. She performed. Excellent voice in person.
How's your name, Her?
She has a real name. I don't know if it's an acronym for something.
I think it's an acronym. It's Dots.
Yeah. You can look that up.
I'll look it up.
But yeah, Her was in there. Black was in there. Jacquees. Everybody did a great job. It was a good show. Mm. It was a good show. And when he did Freaky Friday, I definitely listened closely to all the Yakubians around me to see.
What up, Matt?
Yeah. And you know what?
They said it.
It was pretty silent during that part.
Really?
Not even
that joking. Is surprising.
Maybe in my
Boston?
Section.
Boston?
What was in
Mansfield,
yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was in Mansfield, so.
Fuck this microphone.
But, you know, it was dope. But one funny moment was during the intermission, they were playing, like, Before I Let Go or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a black dude in front of me with his white queen. And I'm vibing, right?
Yeah.
Whoa! So I'm vibing.
Yeah. You hit that note. Good job.
Thank you.
That was quite well.
He turned around, saw that I was a brother.
Yeah.
He had the biggest smile on his face. He embraced the hell out of me. And then, you know, we go back to vibing, and then Return of the Mac came on. He turns around again and hugs me. I'm like,
that's weird.
I'm like, well, are you all right? But he didn't, like, you know what I'm saying? The ones that are like living amongst that whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So he didn't dress. You know, like we
say what you're saying. Say with your chest. What you mean?
He looked like, yo, I needed to see one of my own real quick.
It's been a while.
Yeah, it's been a while.
Okay, home. Okay.
Like he doesn't want to get out, but like it was nice to step out for a second and then go back. But yeah, it's a dope show, man. And then on Friday, Baltimore, kick it with the fellas. H, Wah. No, not Wah, he didn't go. F E Wah. H, Shenny, K, Nick, Sleep, what up? John, what up? All the fellas, we had a great weekend. Yeah, man, I'm not gonna get all into it, but yeah, it was good to be with the guys. It was a good time.
Yeah, give me guys.
I'm envious.
Don't be envious, Darren.
Yeah,
he's with you every week.
Right,
you're a guy.
True.
Yeah, man. What you doing? We do.
I'm
like
the least
cool
favorite guy here.
Don't do that.
Yeah.
But he is though.
Okay, you did say that in the thing.
I did because it's true. Darren's my least favorite out of the guys in this podcast.
Whatever, Jim.
Oh, man. Oh, something else did happen to me, and I'm curious as to how you guys react to this, because the guys that I call my brothers are assholes. So there was 7 of us. I'm the smallest of the seven, right, if you can picture that. So we're taking Ubers around. You got to get. You got to get the XL. So we get some that are decent size. You know, we could fit all in there, squish a little bit. But we got one that was like a Pacifica or something like that. It had a third row, mm-hmm. but the height ain't there. Mm-hmm. So I'm in the third row to the far left, sitting on the arm area.
Yeah, you in the corner. Yeah. You're riding bitch.
And then, oh no, well, I was on the left. Oh, so, okay, and okay. somebody was in the middle and then somebody on the right. Mm. Bro. And bro, broette. I, yo, it was so tight in there. I think I'm claustrophobic. Like my chest started to tighten up.
Really?
Yeah, I had to like close my eyes and do a breathing exercise for the ride. So
that's what she said.
Shut up. So I so
I'm now I have that image in my head like
don't do that, don't do that. Stop. Don't do that. Don't do that. Why am I even seeing this? Why
I'm sorry. So did you get through it? Did anybody notice you were having a panic attack?
Nah, because I was wild quiet about it. I just kept my head down and whatever. So I almost said, yo, pull over. I almost told the driver to pull over so I can get out. Because I had that feeling like, yo, if something happened, I can't get out. And it was freaking me out inside. So we get to the crib. I get upstairs. I do something to calm myself down. And I share with my brothers. Because that's what you're supposed to do, right? Like, yo, fellas, man, I don't know what happened, dog. I think, like, I'm claustrophobic. I had, like, a little panic attack in the whip. And they're like, yo, you good? Like, yeah, you know, I'm good now, but just in the, like, yeah, you sure you good?
Yeah.
Yo, you old bitch ass, bro.
I was like, if they don't know, they now know. They're going to get on you for it.
And then proceeded to get on me for the duration of the trip as soon as we get an Uber. Hey, driver, can you open the window? friends, how many of us have them?
I'm no longer envious. I didn't go because that would have been me. They would have ragged on.
Yeah, so that was my trip. A love-hate thing with my guys.
Sorry, Ben.
It's okay. How was your weekend,
I'm glad you're well. Thank you. Weekend was good. My cousin came down from Connecticut. I haven't seen her in a minute. So it was good to spend time with her. Had a couple people stop by. We just chilled in the house mainly, cooled out.
Do we know this cousin?
Nah.
Okay.
My cousin Flo Dean. Shout out Flo. But no, we just chilled in the house, which was actually nice. Didn't have nothing to do. That's it. Nice, quiet.
I can dig it. Jen.
Jen.
Now that you have time.
Our friend Jen.
I don't know.
Come on.
I had a whole hour to think about it.
The Kokahina.
The what? Don't say that in the mic. Fez is listening watching.
You're right.
On Facebook.
Hi, Fez.
Hi, Fez. Hashtag hey, Fez, hey.
Hey, Fez, hey.
I feel like I did stuff this weekend because I feel like I was tired at the end of it, and I feel like I said to myself next weekend, keep your black ass at home, but I don't know what I did.
You really don't remember. It do feel like a long time ago, though. Like, if I didn't write stuff down, I would have forgotten.
We're just old.
Is that what it is? Do you be drinking that much soda?
Like he's a 5-year-old.
Right? It's almost surprised he's not holding it with two hands.
It's almost your bedtime. You don't be able to go to sleep.
Mommy said I couldn't, but I did. Whatever, guys.
Oh, man. So, yeah, I feel like stuff happened per usual, but of course, not important stuff.
No, none that we pay attention to.
Yeah, not like fully. Y'all got anything?
Before I forget,
yes.
Happy Independence Day to Liberia.
Oh, hey. LIB, LIB. Happy Independence Day, y'all.
Shout outs. I saw that. I was like, hey, that's.
Enjoy some Czech rice. Yeah. Some, what else they be eating? Some Nigerian jollof.
See, that's how you start race wars. I did not say that, people.
Nah, shout out to my Liberian people, man. We love y'all. West Africa all day, huh?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Oh, we got to do Gen Snacks.
So this is like an express version of Gen Snacks, yes. And we're going to play the jingle somewhere around here.
For those who are joining us live, this is our segment Gen Snacks, where our dear friend Jen treats us to some deliciousness. This week, Jen.
Yes.
You want to tell us what we got going down?
Explique.
I promised my friends I would make them sandwiches last week because those who know me know sandwiches is the kind of thing I do. So I went to the deli and got us some meat. So in the sandwich, it's they're slider size. They're small sandwiches. They're on Hawaiian sweet rolls.
So delicious. Mm.
They have fresh baked turkey, Cajun turkey, and bacon lovers turkey with American cheddar cheese. Yes, the lady told me it's a blend. Spinach and fresh sliced cucumbers.
Now, you said turkey, bacon turkey?
Bacon lover's turkey.
Bacon lover's turkey. I don't even know what that means. So it just bacon sounds and the amazing. Turkey. Oh my God. Not to be confused with turkey bacon. That shit.
No, I actually like you guys.
So, are we diving in?
Yeah. I'm fucking Jen, hungry.
I want to thank you for preparing this meal for us.
Yeah.
And before we bite, I'd like us all to cheer. Now, let me stop. I'm about to get into it. I'm starving. Mm.
All right. So, I'll talk about something else while they bite so you guys are not just listening to us chew.
Oh, man.
The sweetness.
Right?
And the cucumber?
Right. It's the coolness.
Right here.
Right?
Mm. So, thank you, Jen.
You know, you guys, making sandwiches is really an art.
Break it down. Cause
you guys should have seen her Ghanaian hands. Just hard at work. I felt like it was a documentary, just, you know, like one of those BuzzFeed videos. The labor of love.
Word. Mad love went into this. Mm-hmm. Damn.
Now, if I really was getting into it, I would have toasted the bread, but we didn't even put no condiments on it.
Don't even eat it. Mm-mm. Don't even eat it. Mm-mm. The cucumber, mm-hmm, and the, you said it's spinach? Mm-hmm. God bless.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Actually, no, I think I use regular lettuce.
Regular lettuce?
I think so, yeah.
God's still blessing you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I was going to get spinach, but.
It is good.
We are appreciative.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Jen.
Actually, I'm married, though, so. If anybody out there.
Guys, if you.
I make a mean sandwich.
You know, if you like sandwiches, you know.
Mm-hmm. Husband, mm-hmm, come find me.
I don't want to block my blessing, so I had to put that out there real quick.
Oh, my God.
So, I'll jump into something interesting I had to ask this week. We put up a question. Which
you just shit on my face.
Yo, Jen. Go
she
in.
She takes
in.
Her
no
sandwich
obstacles
cereal,
in the sandwich, man.
I don't
no
need anything in my face. But we asked which mic was the best mic.
That was a great question.
Tyson, Jordan, or Jackson?
Now, I was a little offended that you didn't include another famous Michael.
Clark Duncan?
Bolton. Tell me how am I supposed to live without you? Come on, man, you gonna ignore that?
You're right. There's a lot of mics I missed,
but we'll stick with the colored mics. So,
oh my god!
So,
yo,
there were some great responses on that. Don't look at me like that. What's wrong with y'all? They ain't colored.
We have colored.
Don't talk about Michael. I know you're about to do it. Don't talk about Michael.
So before we get into the answers, What is your opinion?
I say we start with the answers.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Just a few. Oh, you didn't have it ready. I put you on the spit out.
Because I was too busy eating that delicious sandwich. All right. So, let's see. The people. Kay, Jordan, be like Mike. He inspired too many greats, goats, sneakers, and global impact. Honestly. If Mr. Neverland didn't diddle with any little boys, I would pick him.
Not going to lie, that got me a little upset.
Why?
I love Mike, but continue. We'll get to that.
Let's see. Somebody said Phelps. I almost blocked the comment. Vic, he said, Jackson would walk on the stage and just stand there and people fainted. Which is insanely true. What Super Bowl was it? Where he just popped up and just stood there for
the
like
number,
20 minutes and everybody was just fainting and shit?
Yeah, he was going ham.
Yeah, I was live. Let's see what else we got. Somebody says Jordan, Jackson. Somebody said Vic. I almost blocked that one too. So we got a couple for Jordan, like one for Jackson. And I'm going to check Facebook real quick.
That's my work. We can talk about ours.
Yeah.
All right.
I'll see if there's anything interesting there.
Since Jen's still chewing, I'll start. So although it's a great question, for me, Tyson's out right away. So
what? That is my favorite.
Right away.
Tyson's my favorite.
Why?
Tell me a...
Don't matter.
You see?
It doesn't.
Tell me a Hall of Fame boxer that he beat.
I don't know which boxer in the Hall of Fame.
I don't think he's great because of boxing.
Oh, like,
that's not my reason. He's neither. He's just great.
It's great.
Thank you.
Great dude, but the other two Michaels excelled in what they did. Like beyond their predecessors.
What? Are you kidding me?
Mike,
you don't think Tyson did?
Beyond his predecessors that are greats?
So listen. Mike Tyson wanted to pay somebody $10,000 to fight a gorilla.
He's a real nigga. I ain't say he weren't real.
That's not reason.
I ain't say he weren't real.
I've never seen that fact. Shout out to Johnny because he brought it up too. Like
he brought it up.
Well, when you say that, do you mean he? No, no, go ahead.
He purchased it up.
That sandwich was great. Oof,
it really was. I'm trying to hold off on this.
You're smart. Yeah. That's just.
But I feel like how did that conversation go? Walking through the zoo. Hey, zookeeper.
Oh boy.
Hey, zookeeper. I give you $10,000. You let me fight that gorilla.
If anyone told me I would get a Mike Tyson impression out of Darren today, I'd be like, you're a fucking liar.
I didn't see that coming.
That came out of nowhere. Well,
wow. Really, how do you?
It's Mike. You do what you want. The way he was at that time, you just do what you want.
I'm gonna bust his face open.
You see the clip of him fighting with his tiger?
I did see that.
Yeah. I mean, he a real one.
I mean, he's done so much great. That cartoon, that parody cartoon. Oh my god!
I love the cartoon. Mike Tyson Mysteries.
The best quotes come out of that, and I don't even watch it like that. I've seen like two episodes.
I was DVRing it for a while.
I know you were because I got the clip from you.
I've never seen a single episode.
Oh my god!
Well, that's why you don't think life. He's one of the greatest.
You're missing life.
Come on, guys. So we talk about outside.
Hold on. He did that video with Wayne Brady and Bobby Brown.
Oh boy, that was amazing. Mm-hmm. That was amazing. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Did Mike do that?
Mike has a video with Michael Jordan.
But that was he was being himself.
But he was playing ball.
He was being himself. Tyson jumped into another role.
Mike Jackson's an actor. You seen Thriller?
They still were within their realm.
Moonwalker?
One was singing, one was dancing. They switched. No. Mike got entirely out of boxing and went into R&B. And danced horribly, but danced.
Come on, guys. Don't do that. Don't do that.
I'm so happy that I'm not the only one who's saying Tyson.
No, Tyson. Really? All day.
Really? Thank you. I love Mike Tyson.
All day Tyson. Mike Tyson's the best.
I love Tyson, but out of the three.
Thundel Gundel. Keith, please.
Look, I love Mike Tyson. Like,
did you see him on Lip Sync Battle? Whatever it's called.
Yeah, it was him and Terry Crews.
It's tough watching him dance.
Do anything.
It's tough.
I just love Mike Tyson.
He's so awkward.
Yeah.
I just want him to be my bestie.
Listen.
Anytime he's on a game show, I get excited.
So for both of y'all, Mike Tyson number one?
All day.
Interesting. But you're not a sports guy.
Yeah, but I like Jordan. I love Jordan. I love Jackson.
You don't love Jordan.
I love Jordan.
I love Jackson.
Jen might love Jordan.
I love him.
Darren, you don't love Jordan.
I do.
You're a Bulls fan?
When he was on there, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. I'm telling you, the only reason I stopped watching Bulls is because he left.
Me too. Darren, are we the same person?
Might be.
What is this? Damn it, did you guys just become best friends?
Yep. Damn it. You're still on my favorite. But you're trying, though.
Yeah, I don't know, man. He can't be number one on that list. Yes. I think I got.
He bit someone's ear off.
He did.
Come on. See, now I'm a boxing fan. That got me mad.
Oh, that's why you. That's
yeah, because I was.
Yeah,
rooting.
but he was a hell of a boxer though.
Of course, but like, he lost to Lennox Lewis. He lost to
that little British bitch.
He lost to Holyfield. He lost to Riddick Bowe. I mean, he wasn't supposed to lose that fight. Granted, he probably did wild cocaine and did all types of shit the night before.
Probably.
But like,
but he beat a lot of other people up.
Name them.
I can't name them. That was so long ago.
Exactly, because they're nobodies.
They weren't nobodies, except for the Irish guy. He was a nobody.
There were a bunch of nobodies. If you go back and watch his knockout reel or the highlights, I'm like, I don't even know who these guys are. A lot of them didn't even bother boxing again after that.
Why would you?
But the people who are legends in the game, the Holyfields, the Lennox Lewis's of the world, and I know I'm talking strictly boxing, all the other shit is great. I love it.
Wild he was arrested 38 times by the time he was 13?
Legend.
For what?
Knocking people out. Old ladies and shit.
What'd you say about
Darren, stop drinking all that soda, yo.
Darren's gonna piss the bed today.
Hell yeah. Yo, man. And you're like filling it to the brim.
Fucking thirsty. You're such a traveler.
God, you want some watermelon or something?
In a minute.
Damn, bro.
That's not childish. Look at him.
Yo, but I'm torn. I don't know if I have Jordan or Jackson as the top. Jordan gets a slight edge because of the sneakers, obviously, and the influence of the culture. But Jackson, man, I cry. Yeah, I cried when he passed. Y'all cry?
No. Mm-mm.
I did. Y'all ain't love Mike.
I mean, I was sad. I remember I was at work. I couldn't cry.
So the scene was, I was at work. I found out I was fine. I'm driving home, and I did the thing I shouldn't have done. I was listening to the radio, and they were dedicating all the songs for Mike. And see, I'm feeling it already.
Did they play, what song made you cry?
You Are Not Alone.
Of course.
That's a good song.
Jesus Christ. And I just sat there driving on 295,
Every day.
And one tear just right there. Myself. Are you kidding me, yo? Oof. Yeah, man. And the fact that kids still love Michael Jackson's music and all the influences. There's no Chris Brown without Mike.
I will say.
You cried to You Are Not Alone.
I did.
I will say.
Yeah. And I was scared of Thriller.
Michael Jackson's Moonwalker is one of the best pieces of art I've ever seen.
And the video game is dope.
And the video game is dope.
Yep.
But then Mike had a video game.
Punch Out.
No. No, Tyson. I'm sorry.
Oh, Jordan.
Jordan.
Which game?
Win City. Win something where he was throwing the balls. Pause.
What game is that?
He was like, I forgot. He, like, you would get different balls. They had different, like, fireballs. And
it's like on the Haitian like Sega Genesis.
I'll just stop there.
Only stop. Darren had that game.
All right, stop. So y'all got Tyson.
Tyson, Tyson.
And I'm going to go Jordan.
Yeah.
So when Michael Jordan dies, do you think you'll cry?
No. No.
Why?
No? Why would I cry?
Where'd you cry for Michael?
Are you kidding me? Look, all right. So I hated Jordan. I didn't like Jordan when I was a kid.
Oh, all right. Then
yeah. But I can appreciate all the shit he's done. I love the sneakers. I love that he's an asshole. I love that he got in fights with his teammates. Asshole. Yeah. He's I love that shit. But am I going to cry? No. No, he got to live his legacy. Mike went early, man. That was unexpected. Yeah. Yeah, I never got to see him live. Yeah.
I know. It's sad that he died right during his tour.
Exactly. Exactly. We were watching like the practices and all that stuff. You know, they were showing that on whatever channel. And I was like, yo, this is going to be fire.
Hey, did you know about the shoe trick that he did? You know, how he leaned forward and it was just a stupid shoe.
I feel like I've seen a bunch of theories or whatever, but I didn't know what it was exactly.
I remember being hurt when I found that out.
What is it?
You know how he does a lean trick where he leans all the way forward? Yeah. Apparently it's like
stop looking down
shoe.
At your foot.
Like I got the shoe on, like yeah, I right. can do it.
Yeah, like going away from the microphone. Right. I'm trying to talk about it.
I deserve that, Jen. You're right.
Yeah.
They would go to a spot and there's like a hook in the floor.
Oh.
And so he would go on the hook and they would it would support them as they leaned forward.
I love it.
I remember being like, all this time. I guess stupid Darren should have known.
Yeah, that it wasn't real.
Yeah. But in my mind, I was like, yo, he defies everything.
No. But I was just more like, how did they do it? The fact that they did something like that, we'd never seen anything like it. And they
I've
pulled
seen it
off.
Before.
Tell me.
In my dreams.
That's right. That's how legendary he is. Only in your dreams will you see some ill shit like that.
He snuck into my dreams?
Okay. I don't like where you're going.
Okay.
But yeah, no, that's a good conversation. Do any new mics jump into there? No, right?
Nah.
I mean, because Phelps only for swimming, but other than that, he's not interesting. He's not an interesting guy.
He's ugly.
That too. Sure.
Like, he looks like Mr. Potato Head. Like, he looks like his features don't go together. Like, his ears are like, you know, and then his face looks like it's melted.
I'm sure somebody thinks he's handsome.
Yeah. Not me.
No.
His mama.
Yeah.
Nah, she knows he's ugly. You don't raise somebody that looks like that your whole life wow. and be like, oh, no, he's not ugly.
Oh, my God. So, yeah, no other mic. That's a tough field to be in. Like, naming your kid that. Yeah, that's
I'm going to name my kid Michael.
Are you now?
No. Actually, no. Not at all.
Do you know Michael Mensa?
No.
Oh. Oh. Oh, yep. Got you. Moving along.
I'm looking at the comments and I hear you too. I'm like.
Man, I was a little slow on that one.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, shit. Mm-hmm. Right, can topic. I kill the mood?
Go ahead.
Speaking of pedophiles. Wow. No, let me stop.
Wow.
Okay, just to address that though.
Wow.
I don't think Mike did it.
I also don't think he did it.
Yeah, I don't think he did it. So that's why the
okay, never mind. Go ahead.
Not good.
Because there were a few cases.
There was a bunch of cases. Just like we were saying before with the whole Cosby thing. It was like one came up and then I think what helped Mike was that it was clear like a few of them were lying. Like it was proof. Like, no, you lied.
Yeah.
And it was like it happened to a couple of them. So I feel like that helped, but I think it was like too many.
Yeah, how many were there? Do you even remember?
No.
It felt like there were a lot.
No. But and again, I love Mike. Many. I love Mike more than I like Jordan.
Mm-hmm.
Jackson, I like Jackson more than I like Jordan.
Yeah.
I realize saying Mike doesn't help. But yeah.
Hmm.
I'm up in the air about if he did it or not.
Yeah. So off of that, though, and this is going to get a little serious, but we can have fun with it too, cautiously. I was scrolling through
the
Facebook.
We don't know how to do that.
Yeah, can we just not?
No. We don't run from anything here, Jen. We don't run.
We do.
I mean, I run.
Monero on.
So I was scrolling through the Facebook, and you know people post stuff, and there were these folks talking on a TED Talk.
Yes.
You saw it.
I saw the headline, and I didn't look into it, but...
You should have. So there were two people talking about pedophiles and how it should be looked at as a sexual orientation.
Nope.
And... so I'm gonna quote. I'm gonna say a few things from the video. They can't control their feelings, and we do not choose. We don't choose our own feelings. They also said there are people who have not chosen their sexuality, and unlike most of us, will not be able to live it out freely. And the caveat is the two folks speaking.
Ooh, good word.
Thank you. The two folks speaking, women. Two women speaking on this, which threw me off completely.
So there are two women who want to have relationships with young boys?
Not necessarily saying that they are. I think they were just speaking.
But they're saying that pedophile, the nature of that is should be embraced, right?
Oof, I don't like that word.
I mean, I didn't say
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think they're like vouching for it.
Yeah, I think they're saying.
Accepted.
Like it can't be helped that we should.
Yeah.
We should welcome it somewhat.
Right. Like it's who they are. It's part of their being. And nope. We can't just throw a person away because of something that they can't control.
Watch me.
And the watch me. Yeah. The interesting thing about that, about a year or two ago, I heard that in some journal of science or blah, 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 they're trying to sneak every so often when they redo the issue, they try to sneak whatever their word for the love of children in, in the same category as like homosexuality.
That's disrespectful. To homosexuals, yeah. First of all.
Right,
That's ridiculous.
And think about it. There's tons of people in power from the clergy to the government locally and across the world who do this. So they want to normalize this behavior because there are so many people who are going through this. Mm-hmm. So how do y'all feel? How do y'all feel about
disgusted.
This?
Disgusted.
Yeah.
So we're supposed to just act like children want to be part of this?
And as if they have a choice.
Right, and that's the biggest issue, obviously, right? Because you're not at an age where you can make that kind of decision on your own. You can easily
be
influenced by an adult.
You don't have those kind of feelings. You haven't hit puberty, so you're not really...
You don't have
feel
a sexual nature.
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't have sexual urges, so that means somebody has to take advantage of your body as a child.
Right.
No, that's not okay.
It's insane. That's an insane theory.
Now, and on the same token, in this same world that we live in this same country, even way, way, way back when in like... earlier times, people were marrying young ass folks. Mm-hmm. So, like, I don't know if it's just carried on over, even like in some, not hieroglyphics, but like in some photographs or drawings, you see people with what looks young. Like young kids. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know, like, I got a son. Don't even
look in that direction.
Dude. Right. So, but like, it's like so embedded in like some people and it's normalized in some people's minds. Like, I don't know if this thing goes away. They're going to keep trying to normalize this shit. The fact that these people, it was on a TED Talk in front of a crowd talking about this.
Yeah. And the crowd sat there and they listened.
Which you should do, right? You should always hear stuff out all the way.
Yeah, but so far. It's just like if I went up there as a black man and said, you know, we should just start killing white people.
They
I'm pretty
hear you
sure
out.
They would... all rise up and leave.
They should hear you out. Right? Maybe he may have a point.
But it's like, so one, how in topic, like, I mean, and again, I know TED Talks are, they range in, you could be on camera and eat your watermelon.
I ain't going to be slapping my watermelon on the mic.
You be a Negro.
Like a little houseboy. Hey.
So the fact that I know the TED Talks range in fields that they cover. So this field was just like, okay, so it was known this was going to be covered. TED Talk people allowed this topic to be talked about or whatever.
Right.
For whatever reason. I guess to be open to such a conversation, at least some people are for it, some people are not. Clearly, I'm not for it. I think it's beyond disgusting to say people that have this type of affection towards children should be somewhat embraced, or it's be something that, I mean, at the furthest I'll take it is it's a mental disease that this person has. I'll maybe give you that.
Okay.
I'm saying that, okay, for people who like that type of stuff, they have a mental problem. for any further than that is like a no. Yeah. Like I think you have the you know right and wrong. Like we all have that right and wrong to us. Right. We all can recognize it. So you see, like you were saying, a young person who hasn't come into the sexuality at all, mm-hmm. like don't know what does in a sexual nature, and you're gonna put yourself on them like that. Like it's you're robbing that person of the innocence, yeah. their sexuality as a whole. It's damaging to them as they grow up. Like it's insane that you see all that, you see all the damage that could be done in the future, and then go, it's okay, we should be able to embrace this.
Very selfish.
Yeah. What are your thoughts?
And it's controlling.
That's a fact.
Because it's like I can control a child, I can't control another adult. So
mm-hmm.
It's just some weirdo shit.
So let me ask y'all then.
Don't ask me nothing.
From the perspective
ask these nuts.
Of from one of the comments that they made, there are people who have not chosen their sexuality, and unlike most of us, will not be able to live it out freely. So put y'all in position. Pause. You have a gentleman or a lady who identifies that they have these feelings towards children, somebody younger to them. Never did anything, but just identified, hey, I don't know what it is. I just feel this way, and they seek help.
Okay.
What do you do with this person?
What do you mean, what do you do with them?
Like what's to happen with them? Because clearly they can't have a regular relationship.
No.
But so. If they seek help.
They seek
help.
They, you know, get them their help.
But is that something that's corrected? Like if they say they were born with this condition?
Oh, because you're saying like, for example, if they're calling it a sexual preference,
right.
In the same way that we have heterosexuality or homosexuality, you can't get help to make you not straight or gay.
Right.
So therefore, you can't get help to take this away as well. Is that what?
So that's what I'm. Yeah.
That's what
you should disallow. So and that's. No. Yeah.
Because the thing is, even if you get with a child, which is gross, once again.
Yeah.
The child's gonna grow up.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then what are you going to do?
And then
go get another child?
I almost made a joke, and I'm not going to make a joke.
Don't make jokes.
Yeah. Problematic BIM strikes right? again.
I didn't do it, though. I ain't do it. I exercised restraint.
Good for you.
But yeah, it just made me nervous. Not nervous, but like, they'll sneak some shit in. They'll make some stuff normal.
And keep happening until the numbers get bigger and bigger and bigger.
And they come together and say, hey, look, this many of us, we need help.
We need to be heard. We want to blah, blah, blah to children. Like,
man.
You know what's crazy? Remember that teacher who got pregnant by her student years ago?
Yeah.
They showed a thing, like an update recently. Apparently they had like more than one kid, and they got, like after she got out of prison, they like, got married.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wow.
And they had a relationship.
Like a whole thing.
So it was, I'm guessing for her, it's more than like just that he was young. She's just into him.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Hmm.
Yeah. Like, I think they have like two or three kids. I think they're either separated or getting a divorce, but they still are like close and like good friends.
Yeah. Interesting.
Isn't that weird?
It's very weird.
But like the daughter that they had, the one where she ended up going to jail, like she's like mad old now.
That's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Oof.
Yuck.
So yeah, I think the consensus amongst us is
no.
I'm not about throwing a whole person away, but don't try to normalize this behavior because children can't speak for themselves. And you know, that like y'all said, it's controlling. Like you're gonna send their entire life down this other path of God knows what. Mm-hmm. Like for example, Did y'all know R. Kelly put out a 19-minute song?
I didn't play it.
Me neither.
My friend Tisha said that him and Donald Trump should just come up with a death pact and execute it in February for Black History Month. So.
Your friend.
I didn't listen. I didn't listen to the song just now because she heard it.
Yeah.
God bless her, yo.
He don't look alike? He don't look like Mr. Potato Head?
He does.
So we just saw a picture of Michael Phelps and Mr. Potato Head next to each other. Yeah. And there's a striking resemblance.
There is.
It's like if Michael Phelps could get a tan. He doesn't look like he can tan well. He looks like he burns. But if he could tan.
Yeah.
He would look like Mr. Potato Head.
Mr. Potato Head.
For sure. But in the song, I didn't hear it. But from what people said, one of the topics he talked about how he was touched as a kid.
Who's surprised?
Right. So, but look at the path now. His life has gone down. So, who knows what kind of stuff this shit can cause, man? So, yeah, to do that to a child, one without consent. But yeah, I mean, they're not even old enough, in my opinion, to give that kind of consent.
What's even sicker to me is those adults that give their children up to that.
Oof.
I forgot what I was reading or hearing. It was like they caught a mom selling her 4-year-old.
Jesus Christ.
Right?
All
right,
we got to switch topics. Yeah. That's too heavy. All right, y'all got something else?
Cardi B said she's not going on tour with Bruno Mars.
That would be wise. She just had a kid.
I guess.
She got to like be a mom and stuff.
She just put it up that she thought 6 weeks would be enough to recover mentally and physically.
No.
But it's not. And she thought she could bring the baby on tour, but apparently she can't.
Too young.
It's a newborn, you know.
Yeah.
You know.
So.
Maybe ticket prices will go down now. Because it was expensive. I was thinking about going.
You know what makes me upset?
What's that?
Speaking of babies out in public like that. I hate when I see like a 2-week-old baby just out and about with their family. At the beach.
Kicking
it? At the beach.
Right? Like.
Why you don't like that?
Child's too young. Like, okay, so I think I'm old fashioned in that sense. Like Caribbean people, you have a baby. That baby doesn't go anywhere aside from the doctor visits for at least 40 days. Baby and mom.
Right.
Right. And then on top of that, me, I always feel like if I'm like a little cold, that baby's freezing. Right?
Right.
So I'm like, wrap up the baby. Bring the baby home. There's no reason for that baby to be out.
Yeah.
So when I see people out in the mall, the babies can't even just do nothing because, you know, I can still see its veins and the blood pumping through them. Go home with that baby. That baby don't need to be out. It's not that serious.
Yeah.
The pumpkin patch will be here next year.
The pumpkin patch the pumpkin will be here next year.
The pumpkin patch will be here.
Are you addressing
a specific incident? Clearly he was in some pumpkin patch.
Is this not necessary?
Mm-mm.
To me. What were you saying?
I can't remember. I got off of the kid thing. Yeah. I can't. Yeah, that's too much.
If I have a baby, that'd be fun.
Tell us why, Jen.
I just feel like everybody would be like, oh shit, Jen's having a baby.
I would be like, oh shit, Jen's having a baby.
That's the only reaction
you
can
have. I would love to see you as a mom.
Could you imagine? I think I would be
my mom. Illest sandwiches. Yeah. What?
My kids have the best snacks all the time.
Will you be my mom? That sandwich was fire, dog. Oh. There's like pieces of my teeth I'm enjoying still.
Like she's all happy too, like a mom too. Like I'm so happy you
thank
ate.
You, yeah. Thank you. You hungry? Speaking of moms, my mom was home this weekend.
Shout out.
And we made two things. We made corned beef stew because I love corned beef stew.
Mm-hmm.
And we made my first soup ever.
Like?
You like soup?
What kind of, like stew or?
Soup.
Oh, soup.
Soup.
Like what type of soup?
African soup.
Yeah.
Pepper soup. Chicken.
I'm not a big soup fan.
You do hot?
It's hot.
What'd she say about your hair?
She didn't say anything for like the first 2 days, and I was like, the third day I was like, Ma, I cut my hair. She's like, yeah, I know. I was like, well, you didn't say anything. She's like, because it looks cute.
I'm used to it by now.
The relationship between mothers and daughters is so interesting. It really is.
How long can you guys be together before you guys like butt heads?
3 days.
Sounds about right.
Tops.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like this was a great visit that she had this time. There was no problem.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I was happy to see her. I was helping her stuff and she was helping me with stuff and I didn't yell at her. I'm a very impatient human being. She grinds my gears sometimes, but this was a great visit.
You call her Ma or Alice. Her name? Oh, Alice, huh?
Or Mom. You know what's funny? You know how last time I told you guys about how I got my name?
Yeah.
I know I told you guys, but I'm gonna tell the friends.
Tell.
Oh, speaking of, I have something else to address before we leave.
Should I write that down? Are you gonna remember?
No, I remember. I put it in my phone. So the very next day after we recorded, I called my mom or she called me and I'm like, Mommy, and she's like, Genevieve, and you know, we do this gay shit, and she's just like saying my whole name and stuff, and I was like, and then she said, oh, my little newscaster, and I was like, you know, I was just telling my friends about that yesterday, about the whole, how I got my name, and then she was going on, and I was like, yeah, and then I told her about how I made the joke about Nigerians' names of like God's blessing, and my mom's equally racist, so she's like, ha, 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 that's so funny.
Terrible.
And she's like, yeah, you know, the Nigerians, all their names are the same. Shola, Ebeka.
Oh my gosh,
it made me
it's
laugh.
It's funny because it's true.
It's true. You guys think I'm the worst. She like she went in and I just laughed and she laughed and I said, I guess I'm you.
Yes. Yes. You are your mama's daughter.
I am my mother's child.
But you should love us.
I love you Nigerians. I even love you Haitians.
Even.
Hey, even.
Even.
Even though you guys just hate.
Lord. Yeah, we can't take it no more.
What else we got?
So,
oh, no, Jen's going to hit hers. Right. Go ahead.
Yeah.
So, last week we talked about you going to jail.
Oh, boy.
Remember that?
Meaning Darren, right?
Darren.
I'm a law-abiding citizen.
No, we both went to jail.
Darren, but we spoke.
Allegedly.
Specifically, I'm talking about you going to jail.
Why specifically me?
Because my friend Helena.
Here we go. Here we go.
Yeah. She was livid.
Ooh-wee.
Why?
Did she hear the episode?
Yeah, she
heard that.
Yeah, because she sent me like a, really?
She's livid because you mentioned the fact that she hesitated to come get you because of Zumba, but you neglected to mention the fact that she came and got you.
Yes.
She was the one who came and
that's
got
foul.
You.
I mean, but.
That's foul. Yeah, that's foul.
Okay, you're right.
I thought you said your mom came to get you.
She did.
With Helena.
This guy left out pertinent information. I was over here thinking the worst of Helena.
No. Yeah. But I never said she.
And then she said.
Yeah, you never said she came.
I didn't.
And she said, yeah, I was almost late to Zumba going to get his ass.
Wow.
So she made it to her Zumba class and came and got your black ass. So
you better sing an apology or something.
Mm-hmm.
Helena, I'm sorry. Helena, I apologize.
Yo, how you leave that part out, though?
So who else came with your mom and Helena?
Good.
Wait,
good.
What? Wait.
God didn't like what you just did. And that's why you hit your head. Hey, bon pou. Hey, bon. Salope.
Wait, do I know this answer?
No, I'll tell you later.
Oh, Spice? She gonna text it to me.
Salope. Anyway.
Hey, I'm glad, Jen, I'm glad you brought that up on the mic,
right,
man.
You're right.
I told her.
I deserve to go.
Nope. That's foul, man.
Yeah, that's okay.
I was thinking the worst of her.
We are live, and we put up.
Why are we still live, first of all?
Yeah, because the people need to see us our face.
And the thing's mad far. I'm not going to get up.
I'm going to get up in a second. But before I get up to shut off the live on this, we wanted to shout out our dear friend, Frostman Brilliant, who was on the show a couple,
what up?
There is a reggae festival going down in Connecticut.
Labor Day weekend.
September 2nd. It is a Sunday. Busy Signal and Friends. Jen, can you just tell us who's going to be in the building?
Ladies and gentlemen, for the Reggae Festival on Labor Day weekend in Hartford, Connecticut, we have Busy Signal.
Busy!
Charlie Black.
Mm-hmm.
Christopher Martin.
Mm-hmm.
Marsha Griffiths.
Right.
Exco Levy. RC. Right. Frostman Brilliant.
Right. What up?
Capital D. Deja and Yellowstone, all in one concert.
That's crazy.
That
one
is
concert.
Amazing.
Labor Day weekend. Pod Squad, we're going to be in the building. We have to be there.
We have to be there. It's outdoor. It's all day.
Oh, it's an outdoor joint?
Yeah.
It's an outdoor event.
Man.
So basically, it's like a reggae Coachella. Hello.
Oh,
Gotta be in the building.
Right.
Tickets are only $40 for general admission.
That's it?
$40.
That's it.
But because
I'm not done.
Oh, okay, all right. I wait.
If you would like VIP, it's $100, which is a great deal because it includes the meet and greet, front row seats, photos, and food.
Yes, Jesus.
For this wonderful
food?
Food.
Food.
Lineup.
Job blessings.
You know, it's at the West Indian American Center, 3340 Main Street, Hartford, Connecticut. And tickets are available on eventbrite.com.
Right. Yo, that's a hell of a lineup, first of all.
Busy.
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 You know, he
Christopher Martin.
His song used to be my ringtone back in the day.
Which
when I had a Nokia. Who's calling me from an unknown number? Need an answer, no unknown number.
Not pick it up if it's a private call.
Gangsta, no answer, no private call. I'm about to make that shit my ringtone tomorrow again, yo. That shit was lit.
What? But so for those of us who enjoy reggae dancehall, this sounds like it's going to be like a concert to not miss.
Let me tell you something. When he does Night Shift.
Yo.
Anyways, so as excited as we are, you can tell we're really excited. We are giving away tickets.
Hold on, so let's let this marinate.
Yes,
ladies and gentlemen, we're a bunch of ain't shit people on an ain't shit podcast,
right?
And somehow we've been blessed with the opportunity.
I
want to
say it was the song last week. The Jesus Won't He Do It?
Oh yeah,
Jesus Won't He Do It? And guess what? He did.
He did.
Hallelujah.
Yes, he did. Amen.
So we have tickets.
We are giving away tickets.
To provide. I don't know how we're going to give the tickets
we
away.
We haven't figured it out,
but keep staying tuned.
Yes.
Yes.
We are giving away tickets. Again, we'll be there September 2nd. Labor Day weekend.
Working on it.
Stay tuned for details. Follow us on Instagram, PLSDELTHIS. On Twitter, the same. Facebook, please delete this. If you're watching us now, then follow the page so you can get the notification. We got a YouTube channel. We got the clips up. Follow us. Engage with us. Stay tuned because we're going to drop the details on how you could win tickets. And you definitely don't want to be don't want to miss it.
Yeah.
Also, I forgot what I was going to say. Shoot.
That's lovely. Mm.
No? Oh, so for my people who love Caribbean culture, Jamaican, reggae, soca dance, all that good stuff. Mm-hmm. If you've ever been to the Parkway in New York, it's always Labor Day, which is that Monday. So if you go to the show in Hartford on Sunday, then you're already close to New York.
Oof,
and then you can well. Just go to the Parkway on Monday.
Might as well.
Just make Labor Day weekend just a whole event.
Right,
get you
right.
An Airbnb somewhere.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Keep it lit.
Right.
So it's going to be an amazing weekend. And yes.
Be there. Again, stay tuned because we're giving away tickets.
And don't even for the people who like are moderately into reggae, even if you know you only know a few songs, you can win some tickets from us.
Yo.
And come through and experience the something you've never seen before.
Yes.
So just stay tuned. We're giving stuff away, beloved.
Yeah, it's free.
Us.
$3.99.
Who'd have thunk it?
Right?
We like, out here.
Right? We're like Santa Claus.
Right? All of that. Father Christmas.
So foreign.
Father Christmas. One more thing. While we're talking about the beautifulness of reggae and dancehall in Jamaica itself, we also want to shout out.
The word is beauty.
Did I say beautifulness? I can make up that word. Whatever. We also want to shout out our dear friends at Jari for the second annual Jamaican Independence Day celebration going down August 4th. Tis a Saturday. Starts at 12. It's at Hope High School, 324 Hope Street in Providence.
And our boy Frostman will be performing there as well.
Yes, indeed. Big up, Frost. Another great event that you should not miss. Family friendly. There's going to be food, music, dominoes, soccer, family sporting events. Everything is family friendly, so bring the kids out. A dance hall competition, if I'm not mistaken. Follow our friends Jari, Jari, J-A-R-I underscore Unity on Instagram. You can also go to their website at JamaicansRI.org for more info on that. We'll definitely be there as well.
For shiggity.
If I'm not mistaken, there's an after party that goes along with that.
At the Met.
At the Met in Pawtucket. All the info is on our Instagram, on their Instagram. Look for it. So there's a lot of great events coming up, people. Again, we'll be in the building on the 4th. We'll be in the building on the 2nd of September. We're giving away tickets, so definitely follow us. Stay tuned. Chip.
Hey, watch this little podcast bubble, huh?
Right?
So it's bubble, like Jen Stew. Right. Like Jen's soup.
Oh, that was good.
And we hot. Huh?
But I don't eat fufu, so I eat my soup with rice.
Yeah, no, I do it with rice. I haven't had gyro fufu in a long time.
I'm gonna shut this.
Where you going?
Good, bye.
Oh, I got it.
Do
I
it.
Got it.
Yeah, continue.
I'm gonna talk to Darren. What are we gonna talk about?
Talk to Darren.
Talk to me. Talk to me, baby.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, all right. So let's see. Hey, Jen.
Yes, Darren.
Have you ever done anything illegal?
Have I ever done it? Are you the feds? Is this a
setup?
No,
it's not a setup.
You know, if you're a cop, you have to say so.
Oh, you know
what?
You're right. Let's skip over that because, you know, I was going to say what I did illegal, but.
Right.
Yeah, so I can sort of, if I could just, let's go. Him with the dreads. The Jamaican with the dreads.
I have something important to talk about.
Nah.
Elections are coming up. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's important. We see what happened the last election. Everybody was like, oh, we don't need to vote. And now there are a lot of people who are upset, but it's like, you can't be mad if you didn't vote. There are local elections, which actually affect, to me, I think local elections are more impactful on my life than national ones.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I feel like the mayor of the city is more important than who's going to be president, to be honest.
Because it directly affects you.
Yeah, exactly. Yes. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So the election for mayor of Providence is coming up, congressional elections and everything. So I think the deadline to register to vote, if you haven't registered before, is August 12th.
Mm-hmm.
And elections are September 12th, if I'm not mistaken. So, mm-hmm. You know, ladies and gentlemen, it's important. Get out there, register, get ready to vote. Voting is fun. It's free. It's your
duty.
Civic duty and your right if you are a citizen.
Nieves, sorry, Darren.
Nieves, come vote with us this year.
Living in America. Speaking of Nieves, are you still doing your public service announcement?
The salt?
Yeah.
I didn't know that was a PSA. Oh, my PSA's
your
done.
PSA,
yes, go vote.
Oh, actually, let me ask you. How do you know? So I don't watch the news. So how do you know about your local officials and what they're all about?
And that's the thing.
Whatnot?
I haven't started checking, but for me, I just go online and I Google and kind of check what's going on and, you know.
That is a sensible thing. I'm stupid. I'm sorry.
It's cool, bro.
So, like your local, whatever, to figure out who's running and then what they stand for and whatnot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Plus, they, you know, when it gets closer, they start coming. It's like they come to the doors, depending on.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They'll knock on the door, like, "Hey, I'm running for such and such," and blah blah blah, and like, "Okay, cool."
You know what I find amazing about that is that the people running for office, maybe not like mayor, but like for the council, are getting younger and younger. You saw Karen?
Karen, yeah.
She's running for council in Pawtucket, yes. If I'm not mistaken.
Maybe we're just getting older and older.
That, I was going to say it, but.
God damn it.
It's kind of how it works, man.
God damn it, Jen. But I think it's amazing that, like, yes, you know, people our age want to get involved in politics and take that stand, and
we should
and take the stand. Yeah, as we do not do any of that.
Oh no, that's not our thing.
Yeah.
You know, I finally
it's for the better that we don't. Yes. Sorry.
I finally watched Waiting to Exhale this week.
I seen it.
And I was like, yo, are the women in this? Are you humming again? Are the women in this movie the same age as me and my friends now? And then old girl was like, I'm 33. And I said, oh shit, they're younger than us.
Life comes at you fast.
I wasn't ready for
when
that.
When you look down the barrel of the gun, yeah.
Because you're watching it like, look at these old broads. No. You the old bro.
Because I'm like,
I know what they're talking about.
Yeah, and I'm like, should I know what they're talking about?
Wow.
It's a revelation.
That's kind of crazy.
Yeah, sorry.
Damn,
sorry, ladies. God. You're older than the broads and Waiting to Exhale.
Oh, I don't like you, Genevieve.
What happened?
He looked at his phone.
Oh. She loves you, even though you don't like her.
No, she doesn't like me.
Oh.
I'm the least favorite.
Yet. Maybe not.
Maybe at least favorite out of two. That's not bad.
Oh, ooh. Wow. Well, there it is. All right. What were you going to say, bro?
You came in second place out of two. We asked another interesting question earlier today.
Did we?
Your favorite Beyonce and Jay-Z collabs.
Y'all start. I got to listen and do some homework real quick in the back of class before you ask me for it.
I don't know.
Help. So I'll give you my favorites because I kind of went down the list. So their new album, their new collaboration work they got together, I love.
Are we counting any of those or no, right?
No.
Okay, good.
But I'll say I love, because I feel like there's too many. Yeah. I don't like a lot of their recent stuff, like Shining. I really didn't like Shining.
I wasn't a big fan of Shining.
Well, what was the other one with Khaled?
Top Off.
Yeah, I really like that. One of my favorites is Bonnie and Clyde.
That's a good one.
Good, but only because of the Pac relationship thing. I can't. Oh, I can't write that one.
You're right. But I like the beat, you know.
Yeah.
Lift Off was also another great one.
Ooh.
Liftoff.
Ooh.
Liftoff had like a good triumphant feel.
Oof, that's true. But yes. But that's more like Jay-Z, Kanye, and Beyonce.
Oh, Kanye was in it.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah. Try again.
Don't you?
Well done.
And then there's On the Run, of course. One of my favorites.
On the Run?
I hear it in my head. Is that On the Run?
I don't know what that is.
I don't care. It's On the Run.
Oh, that is a good song. I'm doing a Jay-Z head bop while I try to figure out.
No.
Nowhere near us, I will hold your heart and your gun. Jen, no?
No, I hear the song.
you just wanted to keep doing this, huh?
She's like, oh no, I got this song a long time ago. This is entertaining.
That is a damn good song. Hey.
Yeah, that's a very good song.
Yeah, that is a good song.
You don't have to come. It's okay. You're gonna.
Yeah, no, so what's the other joints we got?
But yeah, so what about you?
Drunk in Love.
You see, I would be there with you, but I remember DJing in South Street when that came out and having to play that like 18 times because all the women, play it again. I don't care, play it again.
Hey, I mean, it don't take away from the great. It's a damn good song.
Mm-hmm. I've been drinking.
Well, you know, Beyonce decided to get nasty. I really shouldn't hate that song because we did that at the wedding.
Yeah, they what?
Drunk in Love. We did that little lip sync to it.
Did y'all do that?
Yeah.
I don't remember.
That was like the last song.
I was there, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Eat the cake, anime, now eat the cake.
Oh, yeah, yeah, but you ain't mush the cake. You ain't real.
Good job, Jack. Good job. I commend you.
All right, so it's not my favorite, but it's honorable mention. There's a joint on one of I think it was Blueprint 2 or Magna Carta, one of the not-so-great Jay-Z albums, Hollywood.
I listened to that this morning.
In the mic.
I listened to that this morning.
How'd you end up hearing it this morning? That's
because I put the post up and then I was like looking, you know, playing different songs.
You did homework for
and Hollywood? But I only played Hollywood. I got lazy. And then I didn't realize title because it was only two songs. I played Hollywood and some other Jay-Z song, and we're just playing it over and over.
Which one's Hollywood?
Sorry. Surrounded by the lights, no. Action, Hollywood.
It's an album cut. It's not. It wasn't a single.
Yeah, but
it's mainly because the visual from like the lyrics, like I see it, I can see it, and then
that song's kind of annoying.
Beyonce did her thing. Why is it annoying? Because of this, her singing.
No. I don't know.
Or is it like
you gotta
too
be,
loud?
You gotta be, yeah. It's a lot of noise.
Yeah.
You gotta be in the mood for that.
But my what's the one where Jay had the verse?
I'm not good with song names.
It's the best for a chinchilla. I've been iller than chain smokers. How you think I got the name Hova? I've been real. The game is over. Fall back young. Ever since I made the change over the platinum, the game's been a wrap. Said you got me looking. Crazy in Love.
Crazy in Love. That's a good song.
That is a good one.
Yo, that joint? Karaoke by itself. It's timeless, yo. That's a timeless.
You know something? So when I Googled Jay-Z Beyonce songs and like different people put up lists.
Yeah.
And one list had just different collab songs, obviously. And there was a song Amil did featuring Beyonce.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And I was like, Beyonce wasn't that song?
What song was that?
I forgot what it was called.
I never heard Amil's album.
No, it was like one of her singles. I was like, I know this song. I just never really realized it was Beyonce.
No, she had one single. Or did she have two?
I think she had two.
Oh, what? Was she like shopping in the video or something like that?
I don't watch videos.
Wow. This was back when B...
I got that.
Okay. You still didn't watch videos then?
No.
Come on.
You think I grew into that?
Yeah. Oh my God.
Yeah.
That was on the soundtrack too, right?
I think it might have been on Night Professor, maybe?
Just something like that. Interesting.
Oh, wow.
Wow. What's the name of the song?
Heard that.
I got that.
Yes. Yes. Nope. Wow.
I knew that one.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a gem.
Wait, so we all had different favorites for the thing? What was yours again?
Drunk in Love.
You had?
Bonnie and Clyde and On the Run.
On the Run. You got to pick one, Darren. You picked three songs.
Yeah,
and one that Kanye's on.
Yeah, you're right. So get rid of that one. On the Run, then.
On the Run. Okay. Yeah, and I had Crazy in Love. Yeah. Yeah, they got some joints, man.
Dangerously in Love is a great album. BT-dubs.
Yeah.
I will say, is that the one? I assume it's on there. The slow version of Dangerously in Love?
Yeah.
Oof.
Heavy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. dinner wedding. Oof.
He just grabbed the nearest person. No matter if it's a woman. He just grabbed somebody.
Oh, yeah. Dance with somebody's grandmother. Right. All sensual.
Are y'all going to the concert?
Nope. I don't do arena concerts.
Well, you do like small venues?
Yes.
They are better, more intimate joints. I'm going to be there, though. I have to. I've seen Hov mad times, but I never saw Beyonce.
Same.
I saw Hov with Mary, and that was interesting.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
When they went, when it was supposed to be R. Kelly?
It was like...
Yeah, they did swap.
I saw them then.
Jay-Z and Friends.
Wait. But then I saw them again. It was just them two. I don't know.
They did do that,
or was it
didn't
like
they?
Mary and Friends? Or I don't know why it was the two of them. But what's funny was... It was Jay-Z and Friends, and she was the other person.
Yeah.
Well, it's funny, you know, I'm there for Jay, Clarabelle's there for Mary. She's a big Mary head.
Mm-hmm.
Mary comes out. She's amazing.
Quite the amazing artist.
Mm-hmm.
So what's funny is she's doing her set. Fellas, this one's for the ladies. I got you a little bit. This one's for the ladies, and she does her lady joint.
Right.
And you can see all the thug people that came out for Jay.
Just scowling,
because they, you know, they feel the married joints, but they can't show it up. Whatever.
Yeah.
40 minutes later, ladies, it's for you guys. Fellas, you got your little time, right? It was like a good hour and a half. It was just all Mary.
Was there set that long?
It was like a good hour. Wow. Maybe I'm exaggerating. Jay finally comes on. Everybody's losing their mind.
Right.
Like, looking around. I'm going to play a song. And he goes to the booth and plays a song. And he stops. He's like, nah. Right? He did this for like 5 minutes. And we're all losing our mind. And of course, he goes into a set. And then he performed for like maybe like 35, 40 minutes.
Hov.
And that's it. He left. And I was like,
rock.
Why is it only 40 minutes to Jay-Z and Mary gets like in 35 minutes?
You felt cheated?
I felt cheated. Yo, of course, Clarabelle was happy than the pig and shit.
Yeah, no. But Hov, he's one of the people that could perform forever.
He could.
Like, he got gems.
And not even, like, when he did the B-sides joint, I wish he did a tour with the B-sides, like what he did for that title exclusive thing. Mm. Just bangers, like, and everybody knew the joints in the crowd. Like, mm-hmm. he can go on forever, pause. Chris Brown's another one, because when his show was over, like, you feel like you want more.
It's more.
Like, there's so many more hits he didn't touch. Yeah. Oh, man.
Speaking of, I always try to see Barris when he comes down every year. And every time he gets me, because he'll perform for like 2 hours straight, and he's like, that's so crazy. Old. And he performs so long that I'm just in the crowd and I'm tired of dancing. And I'm just like, I just want you to be done.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's not done. Like, no, he just keeps going. Like, Barris is amazing. He's coming in August.
Yeah, I really want to see him. That one?
I want to see him again. I want to see him at Patty's.
It was during the week, right?
The one at Patty's is during the week, yeah.
Okay.
I've never been to Patty's.
I thought you said, oh, no, no.
Last year I went to Ocean Mist.
Yes,
yeah.
yes.
So I've seen him at the Met. I've seen him at Lupo's. I've seen him at Ocean Mist.
Some would call you a groupie, but not me. I said, but not me.
We just call you Jen.
Yeah.
Have you seen Barris live?
I haven't.
Exactly.
Some would call me ain't shit.
So had you had seen him live, you'd be like, you know what? I need to see him live every time he comes.
Throw my boxers.
No, don't do that.
I'm sorry, just back to the Jay-Z real quick. What would you say is your like, go-to Jay-Z album?
Oh.
Either one of you. I know it's a loaded question.
Boy. It's between, it's cliche, but shit, whatever. It's between Reasonable Doubt and Blueprint. Because I have very, very, very specific, fond memories of listening to those albums while driving. My first time driving to New York, I had all the aunties in the car. And they said, you can play whatever you want. I was playing Reasonable Doubt.
Yeah.
Jay-Z dropped, same time as the Twin Towers, Hove.
Yeah.
And
that's the reason why I don't like that album.
Why?
Because New York, the song with Alicia Keys, and they just play that over and over and over. Like, if I go the rest of my life without ever hearing that song again, I'll be all right.
Yeah, but that went on Blueprint, though.
What was that on, Black Album?
That was on...
Are you sure?
Yeah, it wasn't on Blueprint. Mm. That was... I can't think of which album it was on. But, yeah, that, again, driving, it was a leading into the fall. The leaves, the foliage is changing, and I'm driving through Connecticut, and I was like, yo, this album is fire.
Yeah.
Man, and I could put those on anytime, replay over and over, like, between those two. Yeah. What you got?
For me, it's similar to you. I feel like just after high school, riding around with the Wrangler.
Not the Wrangler.
I used to bump the live album he had. Him and the Roots.
Yo, that's Jay-Z my Unplugged.
Unplugged. Nah. I play that.
That's my go-to. That's my go-to.
That's a good one.
That's almost a cheat, though. Nah, yeah. Man.
Why
that's
is that
like
a cheat?
That's like a that's greatest
everything.
Hits.
Yeah.
Oh, true. Okay.
Yeah, come on.
But that's the one I... Okay, so...
Pick an album.
It's hard with Jay.
Pick.
Pause. I'm going to say Volume 3.
Interesting. A lot of people would say that's one of his not so
volume
good albums,
two though. Or volume three.
Those are my two. Get out of here. Yeah.
What is going on?
Paper Chase was like my favorite song. Him and Foxy.
Really? Oh. That was volume two.
Was that two, right?
Yeah, volume two is the album that made me a Jay stan.
Volume two. Yeah, I used to play that shit religiously. And every time I want to play volume three because I'm like I want to hear this, I always play the Dynasty album.
Yeah.
And I get mad. Like, no, it's the wrong one.
Yeah.
But volume two is definitely my favorite.
Volume two is up there. Yeah.
Volume two. That made me a stan, but the other two like anchored me like this
feels right.
Like I would defend him.
Yeah. In all I would go to war for him.
Word. I'm still defending that jet ski shit.
Which is why the whole Ether Super Ugly thing was so tough.
It hurt. It still hurts.
Speaking of war.
Fuck Jay-Z. That bothers me so much.
You haunted by the record like that? Are you haunted by it?
You gotta put that scary voice, fuck Jay-Z. Shut up, Nas.
I still remember being in URI and Funk Flex was dropping it.
Oh, God.
And he just kept playing.
You keep running it back.
Over and over and over and over.
Jesus.
No, first he did it with, you know, was Super Ugly. Oof. And then I just kept hearing the part with the condoms in the baby seat. I'm like, God damn, that's wrong.
Rude.
That's wrong.
I hate hearing Funk's voice.
You know what I mean?
Oh my God, I hate him.
I'd much rather hear Mike Tyson.
And Mike Tyson being a radio DJ is the thing that needs to happen.
No, don't do that.
Next up, we have a new
a new Cardi.
We have a new track.
Play another hit.
Not the hits.
I thought y'all love Mike. Why are you doing this, man?
This is why we love Mike.
Yeah, all right.
But speaking of what, Game of Thrones, I heard, is coming back in April 2019.
It's still too far from now. July.
I know, but I'm still excited. But I'm just about ready to start running through all the episodes again.
I started. I finished at season two, like a few episodes. That's a lot of damn TV to be watching.
I know, but it's such a great...
I gotta do something with my life. I can't just sit there and rewatch the longest show in history.
Why?
Also, football's coming back.
Hey.
So how do we feel about this?
I feel like now that you two have now given up on football, now I'm like, okay, I'm ready.
Because your team's gonna do it.
I know. Hopefully. That's the hope.
I can't give up on football totally, but I just can't get excited like I used to.
Mm. Yeah, no, the thrill has gone a little bit, and I think maybe because my team sucks, it helps. But, I don't know. I'm not even, like, excited leading into the season.
Like, normally I'd be counting down the preseason. Like, I look today, and I'm like, oh, shit, preseason's about to start next week. Oh, like, it's literally on Thursday.
Wow.
The first game, yeah.
Wow.
That is
kind of crazy.
Yeah. You've been to football games before? No.
I've been to a football game in Dallas. That was pretty awesome.
Dope.
You?
Yeah, I went to a preseason game in Gillette.
Yeah, I went to a Patriots. Who they play? Chargers. Patriots Chargers game.
I have no interest in going to a game in Gillette.
It was really one of the worst experiences ever.
Because of all the Pats fans?
Not even that. Any game that's going to be good, it's going to be after October, so it's going to be cold as shit.
That is a fact.
True.
It's not a dome. They can keep the shit open like assholes.
Yeah.
It's like one of the oldest stadiums, so it's not like you have comfortable seats.
It's an experience.
On top of the fact that it's Patriots fans.
Yeah.
And this is coming from a Patriots fan.
I love the Patriots, but I'm also...
You're not a Pats fan.
No,
I'm... Pats fan. You're not a fan of the Pats fans.
Yes. Darren, I'm glad you got it out. So... I'm like, what, I could just watch Patriots games on my TV in the comfort of my own home?
But it's the experience.
So which is why we went to Dallas. We went to a Patriots game, but it was in Dallas.
Hell of a stadium in Jerry's World, right?
That was amazing.
Oof.
The weather was beautiful.
Because you were inside. Did they open the...
I think
no, they can't open it, can they? Because they have that big-ass TV?
No, I think it was open.
Okay. Damn.
That TV is fucking... It's insane. Man.
I got to get there.
You have to.
But no, I will not.
Oh, no.
I'm standing firm.
And I'm still angry because, once again, I know I said this before, we wanted to go see Jacksonville, and then now they're good, and now the tickets are expensive.
That's funny to me. So, that's like my LeBron situation when I'm going to L.A. He kind of messed it up for me.
Yeah, so screw them.
Mm-mm. But yeah, the football season, I mean, I watch a few games, and I think not having cable helps because I'm not on Red Zone all day.
Yeah.
Right? So
I need to cancel that shit.
Did you? You need to did? You're not going to do it.
I need to.
You won't.
I will.
No.
Don't judge me.
You guys don't like talking about stuff like this, but can we talk about relationship real quick? Relationship stuff? Love stuff?
Do we have a Love Doctor theme song for this guy?
No.
Do we have,
was I supposed to make one?
I made one. You didn't chop it up.
Yeah, I got to chop it up.
How Darren was soft. Like he really shrugs his stupid little shoulders while he's like,
no, can we talk about love? Yeah. And maybe we'll talk about relationships.
It's like the intro to... the Miseducation, Lauryn Hill, when
with the teacher,
yeah.
Oh,
you know about love. You know about love.
All
right, get your relationship stuff off.
So this weekend, I told you,
I wish I had to pee. So I could
leave. I wish I had to pee.
I got my cousin came down this weekend, so we had a good conversation about relationships and all that stuff.
Okay,
and it made me like realize just a couple of things, and I wanted to say, looking back on my past relationships, I think it's important for anybody who's either in a relationship, trying to get into a relationship, or just trying to figure stuff out, that you put yourself first in a relationship or in general. Sometimes, like for me, I was in a relationship, and I was putting everybody first before me. I was like, you know, I'll do this for them. I'll do this for this. I got to handle it.
Put that Darren first.
Yeah. I was going to say, Jaheim said do otherwise, but go ahead.
to an extent.
It's good in the song.
But yeah. But I think the thing is, like, if you're not good with yourself, then nothing else is going to work. Like, you kind of need that base.
You mean like establishing yourself in your life or?
Almost just making, like, happy with you before you try to get into a relationship or just expand outside of yourself and be happy with other people, then be happy with you.
You weren't happy with yourself, Darren?
Not for a while.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that.
I didn't know that either.
Holy shit.
Until I realized, looking back, like a lot of shit was going wrong because I wasn't listening to myself. Or whatever. I know it sounds kind of weird, especially as guy talk to say.
No, it's real.
But
I'm actually appreciating you opening up so other fellas can be like you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jen. But it's just like it's a very important thing because I know, like, again, speaking to, I can't really speak on other people, but for a while I was in a relationship where I felt like I needed to be there for X, Y, and Z, mm-hmm. but none of those reasons were considered of me. Mm. Like, I was just like, I have to do it. This is what it is. This is my responsibility. And I never stopped to say, like, what do you want?
Right.
You know what I mean? Which led to, like, just a whole bunch of disastrous stuff. When I finally, like, took a step back and figured out my life and figured out me, and not to say that I have it all together now, but realizing that, like, when you are happy with yourself and you got that base, then it's easier to bring, like, you know, my kids are happy because they see me happy.
Right.
I give that happiness back to them. My wife is happy because I'm happy, and I'm happy because she's happy. You know what I mean? Like, so happiness is, I understand, it's a very fleeting thing in dealing with a relationship and yourself and, like, trying to figure it out. And not to say that you can't be considerate of other people, but, like, you got to be good with you first. If you're not good with you, then nothing else is really going to work. That, at least that's in my experiences. So in talking to my cousin, kind of like, like, I see the progression that I've made from being, like, a shit person.
You were never a shit person, Darren. Don't say that about yourself.
I kind of was.
You just weren't as good.
But it just, you know, it's just that type of thing. And then for those people who are trying to be or are trying to be in a relationship with another person, if you see that there's something up with them in their life where they don't appear to have everything together, just realize you're not going to be able to fix them until they fix them. Hmm. Right. So,
also, April the giraffe is pregnant again.
This had nothing to do.
She was happy with her, and so she was she was able. She was able to, you know.
I'm going to reel this back in because Jen wanted to talk about giraffes. no, that's when I would give my fake advice to my female friends who were going through it and in and out of unhappy relationships. I noticed that they were lacking something, or they weren't fully secure in who they were or knew what they wanted. So, Love Doctor, you make a very, very salient point in using
your good words
and using your own life as an example. I appreciate the bravery, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, it's a fact. In me, I struggled for a long time because I don't know what it was. I don't know if it's...
You was a hoe.
Oh. Don't you have to go pee?
Once upon a time, long ago, I was a hoe. It's a Mariah. It's
not that.
It's a Mariah Lynn
song.
Stop it. All right. Go ahead.
Anyways, I gotta say, these mics are just...
You like it, right?
Yes.
So my issue for a while was I was trying to cater to what somebody else wanted, right? Mm. So fill whatever void. But then after a while, it was like, you know, I ain't even really like into it like that. You know what I'm saying? But it would, after doing all of that, and I'm like, wait, I'm not even, like, getting anything out of this. Mm-hmm. And then after realizing that, it's like, okay, what is it that I'm even trying to get for myself, you know? And once you get that realization, it's like, oh, shit, okay. Now you can go down whatever path and leave a lot less chaos, you know, and as you go. So that's real. That's real. This is the first time I'm into it.
I'm with it.
Jen,
thank you.
You got nothing?
Nothing.
That was a guy segment.
What you mean?
I think women
don't go through that?
Yeah, no, they do, but everybody knows that. So that was good to let you guys have that. I don't want to ruin it.
Okay. It's much easier for us to admit it when we're in relationships already.
Right.
Yeah. Right. And again, in talking to her, realizing where I was to where I am now, it's like, I get it.
Did she put you on the couch and, like, ask mad questions?
I haven't seen her in years. Yeah. So we were, like, catching up. She's in her relationship and trying to figure things out for herself and her partner. Mm-hmm. And it was like, you see something from the outside looking in, and you're like, I remember being that way, or I remember being that dumb, kind of.
Yeah.
And going, like, you know, like, I ended up telling her, like, you're going to have to step back for a little bit and recognize that this is happening. Mm-hmm. And until it gets resolved, you probably won't be able to get past that as much as you're trying. So then it was like, you know, at some point you reflect and you're like, damn, like, I almost wish I had known what I know now back then.
Of course, everybody does.
But at the same time, I'm happy I didn't, because I wouldn't be where I am today.
Say it. Be specific. Get your brownie points. Be specific.
So it's like, you know, like, I feel like we all have to learn
in order like to get better. So like for me, my biggest example is like with my kids, like seeing me now with them, it's like, oh, I wish I was like that when they were like 2 and 3. And I was like, no, it's more appreciated now where I am, like that I'm older and I understand it more and I'm much more appreciative of it. I wouldn't want to, not to say I didn't want to be that way when they were like 3 and 4, but it's like to see the growth, it's like, yeah, it's better. So I think
nobody's born perfect, so it's good to have room to grow.
Some people just want to, I guess, be perfect from jump, but I think the journey to the growth is more important.
Word. Yeah, I'm still growing. Still
every day.
Still learn every day.
Every day.
Every day.
XO. Every day.
It was so different back then.
It really
when we
was.
Used to party and be
as
young.
We talk about growth and we want to go back.
No, I don't want to go back. I don't want to go back. I'm okay thinking about it. I'm good. I am good.
Can I do a quick shout out to our sponsor, Just Right Entertainment?
Go for it.
Just Right Entertainment. Sponsoring this podcast. DJs, Uplighting, Photo Booth. Let us know what you need. We got you. www.justrightri.com. I forgot this. I haven't said it in a couple weeks. So definitely look us up if you need a photo booth, uplighting, or DJs for your wedding, baby shower. Baby showers are coming up.
Are they?
It's that.
Shouldn't baby showers be all the time?
Yeah, is there a baby season?
I don't know, but I feel like I got like 3 of them coming up. I know you had a couple baby showers, no?
I threw one your way. Mm-hmm. I can't remember.
Oh, well, either way. Life events that are beautiful, and you definitely want the best music there at your life event, so why not call us?
Because we're going to be there for all that shit.
Exactly.
You should guys just let me host. I say this all the time.
You really
but
should.
You're not being serious. You wouldn't do it.
What do you mean? I can host stuff.
No, I'm a challenger. You won't do it. Look at you. You ain't like
you
look confident.
You know you want to look at you like, don't put
you
me
can't even
side.
Look me in the eye and say you won't do it.
I'm shy.
I want to host. I'm shy. Can you imagine her trying to host? She's like, hi, guys. Not even looking at the crowd. Just, so.
I heard you're having a baby.
Hey, girl. Hey.
Congrats.
Is it time to eat yet?
Ooh, yep. Oh, my goodness. Yep.
We'll be naming the baby.
I can't.
What else we got?
I got nothing. I felt like there was a bunch of stuff, but I'm
the only thing that I can remember happening this week is kind of whack, and I don't want to talk about it.
What was that?
Stupid 50 and Floyd being dumb.
Okay, so I will say this.
They're just dumb. And
they always go back and forth, but I just wanted to say publicly, although it can be entertaining, I it's very destructive to a certain extent to our image, because...
Our as in?
People of color.
Okay.
Because 50 Cent has the most popular show on Stars, right? Successful hip-hop career. Granted, he doesn't make music as much anymore, but he can still go tour off of his first 2 or 3 albums anywhere in the world, and you know, wealthy and success story. Floyd Mayweather, self-made, you know, one of boxing legends, amassed tons of money in the field. So two successful folks bickering back and forth online. And to the extent that Fox News or Fox something reposted 50's thing alleging, so I'm not even going to repeat it, but some stuff that he said Floyd caused. And at the highest level, or, you know, close to the highest level of success, y'all can't help act like niggas still? like, come on, man.
Yeah, I can't even speak on it.
I don't get it, man. So it's, I mean, I and we laugh and we, you know, we'll share, and we're guilty of the same, but like, I don't know, man. It just rubs me the wrong way. And then if, God forbid, something happens to somebody in their crew off of this nonsense, then what? You know, it's cool, entertaining for a little bit, but like y'all are looked at by the other folks who only see glimpses of what we do, and they'll just see that pop up on their news feed and be like, oh, look at these guys. You give them all the money and they still act like that. You know what I mean? I don't like it.
It was just a testimony to how to be a horrible friend. On both ends.
Yes, absolutely.
Like, I feel blessed all the time. I'm always like, are you just stroking your mic stand?
It looks good.
It does. I'm watching her move it back and forth, and I'm like, this looks right.
She's still adjusting.
We're so nerds. Such nerds.
But yeah, I thank God all the time that my friends that I have, including you two, I've known them forever, right. You know, and I don't have any what you call shady friends or terrible people in my circle, you know what I mean? And I always feel bad for people who I'm like, you must not have any real friends. You know, like you see certain people, and I'm not even talking about celebrities, just celebrities, regular people who post certain things, like even on social media, where it's like, you ain't got no real friends to tell you that's just corny and take that shit down. Right. You know what I mean? Like, right. Like I know if I was to post some crazy shit like that, my girls would be quick, like, yo, what's good? Right. You know what I mean? So I always feel bad when there's people who you could tell you don't really have any real friends. Like, that's just kind of wild.
Yeah.
And these two are supposed to be each other's closest friends, and
right,
like I can't imagine you and Darren going back and forth
on social media
on like social that, media
yeah. In a serious manner,
like
right,
yeah. Airing on, out man. Each other's dirty laundry, like that's just yeah. wild.
It's weird to me.
That's
it's
just
weird.
So wild. They're corny as fuck.
Yeah, and I'm a fan of both, but like that kind of stuff is, come on, man.
Yeah, 50 always goes too far.
Always goes too far.
Every time. Yeah. Every time. Yeah.
Habitual line crosser.
Yes.
Habitual line stepper.
That is exactly what he is.
Is that Chappelle? Is that from Chappelle? Yeah, yeah. Charlie Murphy, rest in peace.
Oh yeah.
Man, but in the same vein, not like to that extent, but Kevin Durant and some of these other NBA players on social media too. You get all this money,
but why can't he comb his hair?
Again, last time this came up, you asked the exact same question.
Because it's always a problem for me.
It's so weird. He needs to let it go. He's balding now too, with the little ants crawling around his head. It's weird.
It's so weird. It's so odd.
But like, he won two championships, two NBA championships. Yet here you are going back and forth with fans on
right,
Twitter.
Right.
Him and CJ McCollum. He was on CJ's podcast, and he was acting like super, I don't even know what, saying, wait, y'all really think you're going to win the West? You're never going to win, or all that. Like, saying that kind of shit. And then they were going back and forth on Twitter afterwards. Like, social media is great for a lot of reasons, and we talked about this a few episodes ago, but the fact that I can see how these people really are, I don't like that. I don't like it, man. I don't like that, dog.
Yeah, but then it's hard, I guess, to some degree, it's hard being a celebrity where people always in your face, always. This is like this morning we saw the paparazzi pictures of Jay-Z and Beyonce on vacation, mm-hmm. and me and the wife were talking like, could you imagine just trying to go on vacation and then popping up and seeing mad pictures of you,
yeah.
just with your kids, like can't even get like a moment by yourselves.
Yeah.
It has to be
frustrating,
very frustrating and nerving.
Yeah.
So,
but even
you gotta.
But that's. That's out of their control, with, right?
Yeah.
They're not picking up their phones and having arguments via
like
social
our
media.
President.
Right. Oh, my God. So the leader of the so-called free world is engaging in the same manner. Like,
in Twitter beef.
I like how you said that.
What?
So-called free world. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know.
he needs to. The fact that somebody took a pickaxe to his star on the Walk of Fame.
Shout out to that dude.
Shout out to everybody who just stood there and was like,
I guess this is what happens.
Because it takes a while to fuck your shit up with a pickaxe.
And he broke it down.
Yeah. It's not like he had a jackhammer.
Like, not like he did it in like 2 minutes.
Like, you got to be angry to swing a pickaxe.
Yeah. Y'all ever use
multiple
a pickaxe?
Times?
No. Once. Just watching somebody.
I never use one.
Tired.
How taxing is it?
It's very taxing.
What the hell were you doing? What were you doing with a pickaxe?
The garbage thing in the front.
Oh, you had to dig up.
I had to dig that all up. I used a machine, but at some point I had to do it by hand.
Mm. This guy being a manly man.
Oh, I tried.
Okay.
Hey.
Look at you being a better version of yourself. Beloved.
You were tickled by that.
I was.
Oh, my goodness. I saw some interesting question post earlier today, and I don't know if you want guys to get into it. You guys ever had near-death experiences?
I was thinking about mine few weeks ago, and I was like, do I want to share this on the podcast? Because I don't know if you guys know about it. You want to start with yours? Is it your eye thing? Is it you running into the thing? That could have been a death experience.
Yeah, you're right.
One inch over, you could have lost an eye.
I don't even want to think about it.
No. I mean, I'll start with mine.
I can't have a pirate friend.
What do you say? a while ago, I had a Camry. Lexi was like maybe like two. Me and Valerie's brother Harry, we dropped him off somewhere, and I remember saying, "I'm gonna take the baby with me." And when we dropped her off, her friend had a kid there, mm-hmm. so they're like, "No, I'll keep Lexi." So we left her there. We get on 95, and the car stalls out. Apparently, it ran out of oil. The engine seized up. So we just made it to the side of the road. You know what 95, it curves, 95 south.
Yeah.
Around the curve, whatever. So I was sitting there waiting for my dad to come. And we've been waiting for a little bit. And I was sitting on the hood of the trunk. And I'm watching traffic come, right? So I'm sitting there, do-do-do-do-do. And something said, like, just, like, get up. And I went and I sat on the front of the car, but still looking back. And Harry was sitting in the passenger seat. And I remember looking down, watching cars come. And I see a car go like this and come right in the breakdown lane. And Harry said he saw my face, like, get big. Yo. And then, like, I jumped off the car. This was, like, maybe 2 minutes after I moved to the front of the car.
Yo.
Smashed into my car with Harry inside. Ricocheted off me and hit an SUV. Send the SUV on its side like this.
Wait, ricocheted off you?
Yeah.
The car hit you?
It hit the it hit our Camry.
Yep.
And bounced off me and hit.
Oh, the SUV. Other car bounced. Okay.
And then sent an SUV on its side and hit a third car.
So the car physically touched your body?
No. Hit our car.
When he said,
I'm sorry.
So,
I'm sorry. Like, I'm sorry.
Are you Luke Cage?
No. Yes. Yes, I am.
How did you not tell us you got hit by a car on the highway? Like,
yes. What? I'm sorry. I mean, I meant like the car.
Yeah.
Okay. The Camry. So had I not moved like 2 minutes, that would have been me actually getting hit by a car.
Gosh.
Yeah. Thankfully, none of us got hurt. And the best part of it, my car was totaled.
So, nice.
So I got insurance money for a new car.
Did Harry get paid? Did he say, my neck and my back? Did he do that?
No, he didn't.
You can't say that on the podcast.
No, he didn't. Sure. He sure can. We sure can, but no, he didn't get paid.
Shit.
But yeah, that was.
He's not Nigerian. We know this.
You know.
I will not say anything.
Their face said it all.
Yeah, whatever, yo.
I remember telling Valerie that, and I was like, yo, had I not moved.
Yo, and had you brought Lexi?
That's crazy.
Because the whole back of the car was demolished.
Jesus. Yeah. Didn't you get in an accident too?
Mm-hmm.
Was that your near-death experience?
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to share?
<Mm-mm>. All
right, so I'll share mine. Freshman year in college, I'm at CCRI. All the homies are at URI. I drive up to URI at night for Midnight Madness.
Mm.
I kick it there way too long. It's like a Thursday night. I got class in the morning. So I stay there, and I'm like, damn, I should sleep, take a nap. I didn't end up napping. So I drive, and I'm driving back for class. Sun's coming up. I'm in like morning traffic. It's like 6 something in the morning. I got my mom's van. I am tired. So I'm in the middle lane. I can't remember that highway, but the one leading to URI. Middle lane of the three lane highway. Yeah, four. And just dozing.
Ugh.
Keep waking up, dozing, waking up. And I just hear branches and like rocks.
Like rough.
I've somehow fell asleep and swerved from the middle lane into the breakdown lane. So hearing all that shit woke me up. So as soon as I woke up, I was startled because I'm driving and I'm in the breakdown lane. Yeah. So I swerved to get back on the highway. I skid all the way across the highway and got into the middle ditch. So there were no guardrails in that section.
Yeah.
Ended up in the opposite direction. The van flipped and landed right side. Yeah. Yeah, and I'm like, whoa, hold on. And I come to and I see like the top of the van is bent. I'm facing the wrong way. And I'm like, yo, what just happened? I see people coming out their car rushing over. And I'm completely fine. And my first thought is, my mom is going to kill me. My mother is going to kill me. I get out the car. The guy's like, no, get back in. I'm like, no, I'm fine. Yo, what happened? And they, all of that. And not a scratch on me. The only thing that happened when I was getting out, there's glass on the seat. And I like pricked my finger. But other than that,
wow.
Other than that, not a thing. So ambulance came.
Thank goodness. Wow.
And yeah.
Wow.
And they were like,
you lucky.
Yeah. Yeah. And they put me in the thing. They had to put the neck brace. I was like, I don't need it. I'm fine. But like, you know, for security.
Yeah.
And I'm in the back of the ambulance and they're like, all right, just, you know, we'll be there. So I was like, can I sleep?
Like, they probably told you no.
You can't sleep.
No.
Like, yo, I'm so tired. Can I just sleep? I got into this because I was asleep.
I beg you.
Yeah, man, but that was crazy. And my mom that called her, or no, I called her when I had settled in and let her know what happened. And she went to where the van was and she saw it. And she said she just cried instantly because it was like total. Yeah. The whole top was dented and all that shit.
That could have been you.
Yeah. That shit was wild. And I don't know if it was because I was like so relaxed, my body just went with it or whatever. But yeah, not a thing happened.
My God.
Word.
The angel was on you, huh?
For real, for real.
God damn it,
Bill. Imagine, and I was like, yo, if that happened and I, you know,
the fact that you went from here and swerved over without touching anybody else.
Both ways. So to go from the middle lane over there and then to come all the way back across, didn't even touch another whip during like early rush hour traffic.
Amazing.
Yeah. Crazy. So if there was no BIM, there's no Dylan. You know what I'm saying? Like that ricochet or that series of events.
That makes me sad.
Don't be sad, man. Genuine to yours now to darken the mood.
It's a good
one. I was already thinking, I'm like, we don't have that many funny things happening in this podcast. Now you guys just completely just
Come on.
Well, the ones I read, I won't even share the ones I read.
Did
I
you just, post something asking about
no,
that?
No. Oh. I was on Reddit and I was like, oh, whoa.
Really?
Whoa.
No, yeah. We can move past death. Next.
Next.
You said you were going to tell us about your embarrassing thing after Maryland.
No, we don't have enough time.
No, we have plenty of time.
How much? No, Darren, we're up, right?
No, we're not.
Can I save it for next week? I didn't prepare mentally.
I feel like, I think it needs...
Can you guys...
It needs energy. It needs strength.
Is episode 25
Are you going to be bold and courageous?
I don't want to.
Fine.
Can you guys share something like almost embarrassing next week too?
Sure. I haven't done anything embarrassing.
You're a liar, Jen.
Besides the trash can thing, we already talked about it.
Nothing else embarrassing at me.
Speaking of bold and courageous, we were grilling and, you know, the grill caught on fire and flames.
When the hell did this happen?
A couple weeks ago.
This guy, I like
flames,
nothing.
Flames are going up and I'm like,
wait, what?
I just need to be bold. Not today. I was like, shut up.
How'd y'all should cut it off? You said to turn the gas off?
I wasn't going back there with the guy. It was like super, super high. So we opened it and I forgot.
Did the wife do it?
No, I did it.
Oh, okay.
I did it. Her parents were there, so I had to.
You had to, yes.
Yeah.
Next week, I will share the story. Can we ask the people to share like an embarrassing story, and maybe we can start with their shit before I get into mine?
We can certainly try, Bim.
I need help because I can't be the only one out here on the island with this story. I hate this story. I hate that I shared it with the homies.
Is this solely you?
Yeah. Well, somebody else joins later, but I'll explain.
All right.
It's so bad.
Yeah. Should we get the shout outs?
Yeah. Who's up?
Don't look at me.
Usually you start. Or is it me that starts?
I
kind of have a shout out.
Yeah.
You always start. Have a shout out. Right. You go.
No, I didn't have them last week. And like a couple weeks before. So shout outs go to the nurses on strike down at Rhode Island.
Is
Hospital.
That what's going on?
Yes, they are striking.
I just saw purple. And
where have you been?
I saw it on the internet.
Interwebs.
On the interwebs. So, but I didn't know what was going on.
Yeah. So they are on a 3-day strike. For unfair working conditions, lifespan. They went to the negotiation tables, their union and lifespan, and lifespan wasn't budging, wasn't trying to give them what they deserved.
Yeah.
So they went on, they organized a 3-day strike. It's been in effect since Monday.
So who's working?
The hospital hired temporary nurses.
Scabs.
So rather than give the nurses the benefits and pay that they deserve, they went and spent $10 million on temporary people.
Oh, my God. Grinds my gears.
Right? Stupid shit like that. And so lifespan, obviously, is doing well for themselves.
Yeah.
But they are not paying the nurses, the staff, the benefits and pay. You know, a lot of them are overworked. They're underpaid. Yeah. You know, it's... The hospital can't run without these nurses.
No.
And they refuse.
Nurses are literally angels on earth.
Exactly. Right. I have a couple friends that are nurses. Shout out to Holly. Shout out to Chris. It's just like, why can't you guys just take care of the people who have work that make the hospital great in the first place?
That's crazy.
So stupid Darren had to ask my wife, like, okay, so I didn't really understand fully the 3-day. Why only 3 days?
Yeah.
If it's a protest and you guys are on strike for it, why not strike until you get the change you want? Why only 3 days? Because after Friday at 3 o'clock, they go back to work.
Oh, that's interesting.
Right, which I thought was like weird. So Clara had to break it down. The purpose of a protest, of a strike, is to cause chaos.
Yeah.
And that's their number one goal. And in striking and doing so, they've made a lot of chaos.
Mm-hmm.
Rhode Island Hospital, I think, is one of the only hospitals in the state that allow helicopters in.
Yep.
And because of that, helicopters can't get in. They had to shoot them out to Boston to other states, which is a very big problem.
That's
because
huge.
Because those patients, rather than being here, now they got to fly out somewhere else to get the care they need. Rhode Island Hospital in Lifespan is one of the, I think,
best hospitals in the
Rhode Island Hospital. Yeah.
Yes, I want to say that. Don't quote me. So the fact that you have these caregivers not in hospitals but on the street striking, and now you got those temporary people who don't probably don't care as much as our nurses and staff.
Yeah.
You know, now you're putting the patients inside that want that care, you're putting them at a big disadvantage because you just don't want to give them what they need. They have families, they have lives, and you know, they're giving a lot of themselves. It's very taxing.
Yeah.
So shout out to them just for doing that and taking that stand. We stand with you, proud of you. Clara was supposed to go down there. I don't know if she made it down there or not. I don't think so because she's still here. That would be cut out.
Yeah, that's you know, that's tight. I had no idea what was going on, mm-hmm. nor did I look. Mm-hmm. So I'm glad you were you were knowledgeable enough. Yeah, no, shout out to that, man. Yeah. Like nurses, teachers, like the people who really like keep the
we
society
need those
going.
People.
Like we and they work, like you said, so many hours.
Yeah.
It's crazy
amount, and it's not even like they do it just because it's a job. Like they care.
Yeah,
like a lot of these patients. They actually want, they know that the nurses and the caregivers, and they feel more comfortable with them rather than some smuck who just trying to get by for the next couple of days.
That's crazy.
So it's just like, stop being a greedy company and give them what they need.
Dollar signs, man. Thank you, Darren.
You're welcome.
My shout out. Over the weekend, I wore a very dope shirt, at least in my opinion.
Mm.
Yes. And I'd like to shout out the artist, the creator of the shirt. His Instagram is prophet_art. So PROPHETE_art. So anybody that's a fan of Martin knows the classic episode, the title of the episode is Suspicious Minds, but it's where he recreated the legendary New Jack City scene where they're all dressed in black and he's interrogating his friends about who stole the CD player. So the beloved, the dog, the stuffed animal Rottweiler that he had. Classic. So yeah, Prophet Art on Instagram, he recreated the art himself in his own way. And people were feeling it, so he decided to throw it on a shirt. And it's images from each scene on the shirt. Super dope shirt. We'll post it on the on our Instagram and tag him as well. But yeah, shout out to him. And I'm all about like supporting people who are creative, doing dope things, and encouraging them to do more. I could have spent that bread on a Champion shirt or whatever these kids are wearing or some other thing. But somebody that actually put creativeness and
creativity,
thank you, into their craft and put it out there for us for free. Like we get to view it on Instagram and screenshot it if we want, put it as a background. He doesn't get anything. So you put a product out there, I'm gonna support you, my brother. And if anybody else is digging it or other stuff he got, support. And you know, any other small business owners, which I'll call them, on Instagram who are doing their thing and getting their hustle on, support. So yeah, shout out to him. Jen.
Yes, Bim.
Do you have a shout out?
Yes, I do, Bim.
Oh, shit.
Proceed.
Thank you, Darren.
What is going on?
First of all, I'm very subdued today.
Because?
Because I'm growing up.
What is going on, yo?
I'm mature.
Because I'm growing up.
I'm a lady.
I'm wearing my big girl pants.
That's right. I will shout out to us for reaching episode 25.
Is that a mile mark?
Because I didn't think we would do more than one.
That's a fact.
You guys convinced me to try it.
Hey.
You guys have broken all the promises you made me.
Also true.
I said I would do it with no cameras, looking at a camera, no live, went live.
Yeah.
No appearances, just scheduling appearances. But, you know, this is fun. And shout out to our podcast. And shout out to my friends. And shout out to me not throwing up because I'm shy. And shout out to the snacks. And and sharing beverages and watermelon. We didn't put salt on the watermelon.
Are we going to do it? Should we do it while on the thing?
Nah.
You shame Nieves on the mic. For
whatever,
and you didn't shout out Helena for coming through for you.
Helena, thank you. So I said, how's the song
I still can't believe you did that.
Helena,
yo.
I forgot.
No, seriously,
I didn't forget.
Hold on. I usually give Darren a pass, Jen, and I'm gonna grab one of these watermelon. You're gonna sprinkle some of that stuff on there for a player. So I usually give Darren a pass because I love Darren. He's my friend. But I really was angry with Elena because I thought she left you high and dry for some Zumba.
You're right.
And she actually came through.
She did. Came through and she went to the Zumba.
She did.
Are you kidding me?
She's a great
she
friend.
She just asked.
She's a
I don't friend. Know what time you need me to do it because I got Zumba later. Is it good? Bim's eating the watermelon with some salt sprinkled on it, and he's making that oh my god face.
Is the watermelon good?
Watermelon's good.
It's good. Okay,
so obviously it's still a watermelon taste, but the sweet and salty always works to a certain extent.
Yeah.
I don't know if I need more salt on it, but
try.
I still take. I'm not. I don't low sodium, beloved. You know, high blood pressure. True. You know what I mean, but
I could do without the salt.
Yeah, yeah. It's like it's still watermelon flavor, but the salt.
It wasn't bad though.
Yeah, it's the sweet and salty thing, but
maybe it's because the watermelon's warm.
Ah, maybe.
I think if it was cold, it'd be better. Mm. I'm gonna still eat it though.
Yeah, Vez, you ain't crazy like Darren was saying.
Oh wow.
You do your salt, beloved. Just watch your sodium levels.
I can always tell when like certain people are watching because they. It doesn't matter like when, like what day. I'll just get like random text messages, and so from her, it's usually like, "Hey, yo, fuck you, Darren." Oops. So yeah,
this is fun.
This was great.
Word.
Anything next week, we're gonna be a little less serious.
Yeah. Oh, season two next week.
Season two. Oh, I like that.
Should we take a week off?
No. Can we talk about what we got coming up on with franchise?
No, not yet. Coming soon.
Coming soon. Stay tuned. But
Bim was pondering taking the week off.
I was.
Nah.
Jen so wants
nah,
to take
the week son.
Off.
I see no need.
Well, Darren wants to record, we'll record.
I don't know who died and made him charge, but okay. All right, guys. Guess see you next week.
Next week will just be me.
It's the Darren show.
Right. Starring Darren.
Playing the spoons on his knee.
I love being in love. Click, 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 click.
And now it's time for a Darren Snacks.
I have a puppy.
Oh, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning in once again.
Thank you.
Have a good weekend.
2-5 in that ass.
Thank
all the way
you for
in there.
Watching and listening and all that stuff. Aggressive. Wow. We're going to end there. Good morning, people. Enjoy your weekend.
Thanks.